Welcome back to Nature News. Today we're talking about just what to do with all that dangerous e-waste you may have laying around your house. Hey everybody, I'm Alice Ford, an environmentalist determined to help others understand more about what we're doing to the world around us and what we can do better. So if you want to learn more about how to protect the planet, then make sure you hit subscribe right now, turn on those bell notifications, and join us over on our Facebook community as well, right here on Nature News. Do you guys ever feel overwhelmed by all the cables, cords, chargers, and electronics in your home? Well, you're not alone. I have that same terror when I open my camera closet and see all of the things in there. And while I would love to throw half of it away, I actually can't because this sometimes junk is actually hazardous. Things like televisions, phones, charging cables, none of them can actually be thrown away in your household garbage. Yet that's where a lot of it actually ends up. Now, all of this junk and almost anything with an on-off switch is actually considered e-waste. It can actually be thrown away, and it's growing in size every year. Now, when I say e-waste, that generally refers to things like computers, TVs, VCRs, stereos, copiers, flashlights, phones, and electronic cables. And while they can't go in the garbage due to containing toxic waste, many of these products can actually be reused, refurbished, or recycled, but they need to make it to the right place in order to do that. And throwing them in your household trash is not where they're supposed to end up, because then they end up in a landfill and not the place where they're supposed to go to be recycled. And here is why this matters. Things like computers and TVs, for instance, contain leaded glass, which is a poisonous heavy metal. Batteries, those carry explosive and cancer-causing elements such as cadmium, lithium, and lead. And yes, they will explode. Just check out one of these YouTube videos if you don't believe me. Some appliances also, like gas hot water heaters and chest freezers, contain mercury switches. And when mercury isn't disposed of properly, well, it can create some serious health issues, such as respiratory and skin disorders. And even little things like all those charging cables you have for the 19 million devices in your closet, the connectors for your TVs and computers, those contain lead and other toxic chemicals that, when disposed of improperly, actually leach into our ground soil and our water. The amount of e-waste on this planet is incalculable. That's because it's actually undocumented. Electronics are pretty much embedded in every facet of our lives these days, but they have really short life cycles. Just think about how many new iPhones you've gotten in the last 10 years. And when the time comes to replace these products, it's rarely disposed of in the way that would limit its impact on the environment. Despite the fact that 71% of the world's population is actually governed by some sort of e-waste legislation or law. Now, the problem lies in all of us, because when faced with throwing something away in the trash or having to pack it up and ship it or drive it to a recycling center, most people choose the simplest solution to their immediate problem, and that means throwing it away in the garbage. Now, I know most of us don't necessarily think about what happens to our garbage when it leaves our home, but we need to start thinking about it. Pollution, waste, recycling, these are not someone else's problems. These are our problems. They are the problems of all of us, and we all need to work together globally to fix them. Sadly, most of the world's e-waste ends up in places like India, Africa, and Asia, where it poisons children, pregnant women, and local water, soil, and air. Now, new studies actually show that it's leading to neurological damage and impaired lung function in children that live in or near these e-waste sites, as if surviving in poverty isn't hard enough. Now, as our societies become more reliant on technology, the dumping of e-waste has risen steadily over the last 7 years. 21% to be precise. And we're only actually sending about 17% of this e-waste to appropriate facilities that are actually equipped to manage or recycle these items, which means the rest of it ends up in landfills or unregulated waste sites where it's leaching chemicals into the local environment and making people sick. And when e-waste is mixed with other trash, that's where it ends up. It just goes to a landfill or it's incinerated, which is even worse. Either way, these toxic elements that lie within them are released. And there's a long list of these chemicals. When they end up in a landfill, they seep into the ground, polluting it, and eventually the large bodies of water that lead to causing contamination of the food chain and drinking water. If it's incinerated, it releases the carcinogenic gas dioxin. All this does is worsen the already polluted air and the air of the people that live in these areas. A new study estimates that more than 18 million children, that's the size of Los Angeles, just so you know, and adolescents, some young as 5, work in the informal industrial sector where waste processing takes place. One of the biggest worries is lead exposure, which we know is horribly destructive to children. Children exposed in the womb, for instance, to lead are more likely to suffer from things like ADD and ADHD, from behavioral problems and severe cognitive problems, and even blindness. The long-term health effects of lead poisoning are even worse, from blood poisoning to reduced lung function, respiratory dysfunction, and even changes to our DNA, impaired thyroid function, as well as increased risk of many chronic diseases like cancer and cardiovascular disease. We all need to get a handle on how and what we buy and dispose of. And Americans, we're a huge part of the global e-waste problem as we sell or send almost all of our e-waste to third world countries and are heavily reliant on technology. So I've given you a list of some of the things that you can do right now. First of all, you need to make sure you know what items in your home are actually considered e-waste, especially at the end of their life. And a good way to know this is whether or not it has an on-off button. If it takes electricity through an outlet or a battery, it is most likely e-waste and cannot go in your regular trash. Now, once you've identified these items, and depending on where you live, you can actually check with your local waste hauler or your local state-run agency as to how you can properly dispose of it. A lot of towns actually have e-waste collection days. Here in California, you can actually go to calrecycle.com for a list of local companies that will pick up or accept e-waste. There's also the company TerraCycle, which accepts hard-to-recycle items, and you can check out their website for many of the items that you can send back to them. They even take things like toothpaste and odd containers as well as office supplies, so it's a great company to check out. Many manufacturers are also stepping up, and if you contact them, a lot of them have buyback programs or postage paid labels to send your items back that are no longer in use, and this is really great. Secondly, it's time to be a smart consumer. If you're buying something new, check to see how it's made and what it's made of, how long it's going to last. It always pays to spend a few extra dollars on getting something that is good quality and that is going to last a long time from a good company rather than just buying the cheap copy of what you really need. So look for companies that are using sustainably certified ingredients. Look for companies that are B Corp certified or 1% for the planet members. These types of companies have proven business practices that give back to the earth. And one of those companies is Nimble. Now, Nimble is our video sponsor today, so thank you to Nimble. They make things like chargers and power banks out of actually certified recycled plastic and certified recycled materials. And one of the things I love about them is when you buy something, they actually send you a bag where you can send back 1 pound of e-waste for everything you purchase. They make things like power banks, chargers, charging cords for your computers and your cell phones. And I have already sent back some of my e-waste from my junk drawer. Now, Nimble has been gracious enough to give all of you a 25% off coupon for any purchase you use on their website. You can use the code AliceFord25 at GoNimble.com. Some other companies to keep your eye on are Fairphone. Now, Fairphone is a cell phone company making phones from recycled products that are modular and repairable. Imagine that. While not yet popular in America, go figure, many in Scandinavia and Europe are adapting this more eco-friendly take on technology. And more companies are cutting profits and looking to protect the planet through making a longer-lasting product that we can actually fix. And a few more companies that you should keep in your little phone book there are Amazon and Apple, which both recycle their devices and have easy-to-use consumer send-back and buy-back programs on their website for things like Kindles, iPhones, iPads, and computers. And don't worry, they go to extensive lengths to actually wipe your devices of any old data if you happen to leave anything on there as well. Canon, the makers of cameras, printers, and more, takes back all consumer and home office products if they're broken or obsolete. So that's great. Things from cameras and accessories to printers and calculators. Canon's working really hard to ensure that these things are appropriately recycled. And also the companies Sprint, Dell, and Samsung all have buyback programs as well for their products. So now it's just up to us as consumers to start making a change. Companies are starting to fall in line, but we can also ask companies to do better as well. So I hope you take what I've highlighted in this video home with you and make some changes around your home and maybe even your office, maybe tell some friends. So that's all I have for you guys this week. I really appreciate you watching and sticking with me till the end of the video. If you're not subscribed, please hit subscribe. Don't forget to leave a comment down below with anything that you want to share, whether it be nature news, science, or wildlife news that's happening in your neighborhood, or you just have a comment on e-waste or something else you'd like to see covered on this channel. And don't forget, we also have a Facebook group where you can join us in conversation. It's at the link right here on the channel. You can find it, Nature News on Facebook. But until next week, I will see you guys then. And please let me know if there's anything I haven't covered that you want to learn more about.